Welcome to this App Inventor tutorial. Today we will be building a translation app with the app building guide available on the Youth Mobile Power Series page. The link to this page can be found in descriptions down below. Once you scroll down, you'll be able to get the guide by clicking on the translation app right here. You can find more information about the challenge and also obtain the text version of this tutorial. For the purpose of this video, we will toggle the tutorial away. Here is a demo of what our final product is supposed to look like. Currently, we are in Designer. In Designer, add a label and a text box. And below that, add another label and a button. Let's rename these components for more accuracy when we're working with them later on. You can rename these components by clicking on whatever you want to rename, and then the rename button at the bottom. Enter a new name, and click OK, and you will see that now it is saved as the new title. After you have changed the titles or the names of the component blocks as shown here, you can now change the text property for title label. Change that title label to enter text to translate below. Continue to change the text properties for translation label and also for the translate button. Now from the media drawer, drag out the Yandex Translate component and drop it into Viewer. Note that this is a non-visible component, so it appears below the phone screen right here. This component provides the translation service for text in the app. Next, go to the Blocks Editor by clicking on the Blocks button at the top right corner. Click on Translate button in the Blocks palette and drag out the WhenTranslateButton.ClickDoBlock. Then, click on Yandex Translate 1 in the Blocks palette and drag out the Call block. Add this block to your WhenTranslate.ClickDoBlock. We want our translator to translate English to Spanish, so to specify which languages to translate, we need to tell the Yandex translator that information. Drag out a blank text block and snap to the Language to Translate to socket of your Call block. Click on the blank text block and enter the text en-es. The code works by having the language translate from be set to English and the language translating to be set to Spanish. The language codes can be found on this website. The link to this website is provided in the description of this video. En represents English and es represents Spanish. You can change the language setting of the translation by changing the two-letter abbreviations to a desired language. For this tutorial, we chose English and Spanish. Now click on Text Box 1 in Blocks Palette and drag out textbox1.text. Snap this block to the text-to-translate socket. This code allows the detection of text in need of translation, specifically the text of TextBox 1. Once the Yandex translator has translated the text, it triggers the Got Translation event. Click on Yandex Translate 1 and drag out the When block into your screen. Next, click on the translation label in the Blocks palette and drag out the SetTranslationLabel.TextToBlock. Snap this block into the WhenYandexTranslate1.GotTranslate block. By hovering over the orange translation button, you can grab the Get Translation block. Connect this block to the Set Translation Label block. Now, let's try to test our app with a companion device. If you haven't already connected your device to test, go to Connect, click on AI Companion, and then you can scan the code that pops up from your device to make sure it is connected. Congratulations, you have finished building the translation app. There are various ways you can expand your app, such as changing the language setting. By toggling Open the Tutorial and going to Expand Your App, there are various ways you can adjust your code. You can allow your app user to have the option of choosing the translation language setting. You can also detect the motion of the user device to react for translation. What would you try next?